So for my next recipe, this is a wrap that you can use for lunch. This is what I'm going to make. So it's again centered around the same black beans. So I'm using a package of boneless chicken. Now the same boneless chicken I'm going to use for dinner. So let me show you how to prepare it. So to this boneless chicken, I'm going to add some red wine vinegar. Gonna season it out. Make sure you wash it in some cold water first. Okay. Next, I'm gonna add some sazonador. I'm gonna lightly season it because my beans and my other stuff have flavor. Ground black pepper, ground cumin, and ground garlic. Okay, so you're gonna take this wooden spoon and just mix it with a quick stir. Okay, you're next, you're gonna need a small pot, right here. And you're gonna put it in heat up because you're gonna cook. You're gonna use one piece of, for every wrap you make, you're gonna use one piece of chicken. Okay, I'm just making one for now. So I'm just gonna use one piece of chicken. Let's move this to the side. So to this, you're gonna add a tablespoon of oil, and I'm using refined coconut oil. You don't have to use coconut oil, but coconut oil is better for you. So I'm testing out this coconut oil because I'm trying to make some changes. So this is what you're gonna do. See that there? Have it there to heat up. Okay, you're gonna put that there to heat up. Just as it's nice and hot, make sure you spread it throughout the whole pan. You're basically going to grill your chicken, one piece of chicken. So my pot is hot enough, frying pan is hot enough, nice sizzle. You're gonna sear it on both sides. Put the rest of this in the refrigerator. In the meantime, grab a plate. Chicken cooks fast. So this plate, I'm going to use, it's a wrap, so I'm going to use, this is the brand wrap that I'm using. Mission wraps, and I'm using the multigrain. You can use just the regular white one, or you can use the whole wheat one. I'm gonna take one, put it here in the plate. I'm gonna start plating while that chicken continues to cook. Okay. You're not gonna add any mayo to your wrap. And I promise you, it's not gonna be dry. You're gonna take the refried beans and put about 2 tablespoons. And you're going to spread it. And make sure you keep an eye on your chicken. On the chicken. And your fire should be on medium heat. Okay, now that cooks. Next is I'm going to take the same cheese that I used for the tacos. Put them in the middle. And leave it like that. And next, you already had it cut, which is avocados. So I'm just gonna lay them here and make a bed of avocados. For the avocados, you can put as much as you want. 3-4 slices of avocados. If you don't like avocados, it's fine. You don't have to put avocados. It's just they pair well or with the wrap. So the next thing is you're gonna put the chicken. You have to wait for the chicken. Okay, so my chicken is done. Take it right from there. Bring the extra soil. And I'll put it right on top. Okay. Now next, go on with the toppings. So I'm gonna use the same chimol that I used in the nachos. So you're gonna put a generous amount on top. Okay, to the side, and you're gonna use the Mexican cheese, queso fresco. Cut a nice piece. About this much, so I'm just gonna take it, put it right on top. Yes, this is gonna be hard to close. Let me see if I can attempt to close it for you guys. So wrap it this way, wrap it one way, wrap it another. Okay, it's easier to wrap it when you have aluminum foil. Thank God I have. So we're gonna take this one here. I'm gonna put it here. Just because I want to show you how to wrap it. I tend to wrap my wraps like this, just because when I eat it, I can just pull it down. It's less messy than having it just on a plate without aluminum foil. Aluminum foil helps to hold it together. So, here you go. Here you go. So, this is option number two with the same beans that I told you about. So stay tuned for their next recipe, which will be for dinner. Okay guys, so it's dinner time, and it's time for the final recipe for your frijoles. So right here, I just got a cup and a half of white rice cookie, and then I got the chicken that I seasoned earlier for the chicken burrito. And I've warmed up my frijoles. I have the avocado. I have here the chimol. And here I have the queso fresco. And also the other cheese from El Salvador. So these are all of the ingredients that I'm going to be using for dinner. So stay tuned and I'll show you how I'm going to plate it. All right guys, so there you have it. Three recipes as promised, centered around the same main ingredient, which is your black beans and the ingredients that complement the black beans. So feel free to hit me up and let me know which one was the best recipe that you like, the best meal that you like. And I'll try to keep the recipes coming. Stay tuned for more videos and have a good night.